Prior to coming here, I had been working in hospital systems. When this particular project came open here, it was a really, really unique project that I had never done before. Crisis stabilization is a whole different animal than working with the hospitals. And it gives you a lot of leeway to be able to address the things that you want to do and do them the way that you know needs to be done. And you're not necessarily bound by real strict black and white guidelines that hospitals have to follow. My name is Bruce Johnson. I'm the director of the Crisis Stabilization Services here at Pawnee Mental Health. And my role here is helping operate and run an organization that is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for those in mental health crisis. And we are staffed 24 hours around the clock. We provide services out to about 13 different emergency rooms and 10 different counties. Our facility is actually located right off of Hayes Drive in Manhattan, Kansas. And we're there to provide an open door access as well for people to walk in. If they're feeling distressed or in crisis and need extra help, we're there for that. We have the capability here to be able to have people stay overnight with us. So sometimes if somebody's having a crisis and they need a safe place to be, they can stay here for a couple of days or so, or whatever it takes. And our job is working with meeting that person in their state of their crisis, what their issues and their problems are. And that's unique to every individual.
Every crisis looks different for every person. So everyone comes in with a different level of care that they think is crisis, and it is crisis for them, so we treat it accordingly. And that just goes based off their needs.
My name is Stephanie. I'm a crisis case manager at Pawnee Mental Health Services. Every day is different. So I will go through and assign each case manager with what they're doing and case coordinate every single client on the unit to see what their needs are for the day. And then from there, we just go. And that's really what it is. We just go based off what they need. We get to appointments, we get medications picked up, we get breakfast started and then lunch. I mean, it's just a whole day. And that doesn't include crisis calls or crisis intakes. So we do just a little bit of everything. Every day is just a little bit different.
When the state of Kansas brought crisis stabilization on board and decided it was a program that they wanted to support and it was a needed program, they had a couple of goals. One of those is to provide areas or regions that did not have mental health or psychiatric acute care services an alternative. And their additional goals were, we want to provide relief to, for example, the hospital systems, because without a service like we have here, your only option if you were in crisis was to go to the emergency room. And the emergency room is not necessarily the best place or the right place many times for a mental health or psychiatric crisis. Frankly, they're not equipped to do that. You know, they're good with car wrecks and broken bones and stitches and all sorts of things. But you put one person in there with a mental health crisis and they don't know what to do with it. Sometimes they have a hard time. And that's not their fault. They're just not designed to do those sorts of things. And so it was kind of an inappropriate use of medical resources to be able to use emergency rooms for that as well. Then their other goal was to look at what kind of services do the jails and law enforcement and other agencies need.
My name is Bryn Haberkamp, and I am a crisis therapist with the Crisis Stabilization Unit, and I'm also a mental health co-responder with the Riley County Police Department. As a mental health co-responder with the Riley County Police Department, I work one-on-one with the Riley County officers responding to mental health crisis calls in the community. So that's 911 calls where somebody's having any sort of mental health crisis, whether that's drugs and alcohol related, suicidal thoughts, or kind of anything in between. I'm kind of just like the liaison with the police department, getting the officers more familiar with mental health and how to respond to those situations. Before the stabilization unit was opened, just looking at like the law enforcement aspect, we had one option. We could walk away from the situation, let that person go home, or we could utilize the local ER. And it's that officer themselves making that determination. And that's typically a very tough decision, and especially if you have somebody that's not wanting to go to your local ER to do that. I see my success whenever I see it in other people. So if an officer is handling a call just as good, if not better, than how I would do it, to me that's a success. Since the stabilization unit has come about, I have multiple times where officers are able to go on scene, and the second they hear that somebody's struggling with mental health, they're like, hey, we have this resource in town. Do you know about it? Do you want to go talk to somebody there? And a lot of times we get a lot of voluntary that are like, yeah, I'll go there. I want to talk to them. I want some help, and this is the place where I can get it. And so we're bringing these people over here without having to spend, you know, an hour on scene with the officers trying to figure out what we're doing, or waiting for me to arrive so we can have this conversation more in depth, or figuring out those options. It's made things easier. It's cut out a lot of time for us, and it's been really beneficial for the officers. I'm not your typical therapist, and people tell me that a lot, as far as like, oh, well, you're just really easy to talk to. And I was like, well, I hope that's the case, because that's my goal. So when I have those interactions, those good positive ones, you know, that reminds me every day why I need to be here. We have bad days. I have interactions that aren't great, and those stick with me too. But every day that I have those good ones, or I see the difference, or I see that person, you know, walking on the street a few days later and they're doing better, you know, that's why I do this. That's why I want to do this. And I want to be with crisis for a while, I think, as long as they'll keep me.
So some of the things that make the type of treatment here pretty unique is that we're able to do a lot of things that we're not able to do in a cold clinical hospital type of setting where they're really, really restricted. We're not a locked facility. We're voluntary. If you're in a hospital setting, for example, life stops when you go in. And then it doesn't resume again till you get out. There's real clear, definitive beginning and end to that. We don't have those type of barriers. It's a lot more integrated into the community. We will go out and show people how to relax, have fun, what different types of healthy recreation are. We'll go on everything from fishing trips to hanging out, getting ice cream. We try to show what life is like and enjoy that while they're also getting help and healing at the same time.
My name is Jeremy. I'm a case manager at the Crisis Stabilization Unit. So we work with the clients that come in one-on-one. So the case managers are involved from the moment they get here until they discharge. And we kind of make sure they're progressing and meeting their goals while they're here. So outside of the clinical work and assessment, some of the things we provide for the clients. I love playing pool, so I like to play pool with the clients. For me and the client, that's a good icebreaker. To them, it's a little bit of normalcy, and you know, we're just having a normal conversation. But you can really learn a lot from just playing a few games of pool. You can learn a lot about somebody, you know, pull a lot of information from that. But I do go on the group outings quite a bit too, and they enjoy that. Because they like to get a break from the unit, you know, like a change of scenery, and that helps just to get out, go in the community, be around other people, or you know. They enjoy all those things, so. And with some of the people I've got to work with, like one-on-one, and spend a lot of time with them while they're here at the CSU, and then they turned it around and were successful when they left here, that you never forget that. You never forget those interactions with those people. And so when I leave at night, you know, or when I'm thinking about it, I'm like, you know, that's why I do what I do, because you get to change people's lives, you know? And some of them will never forget you. And they'll always look back and say, man, I remember when I went to the CSU and I worked with so-and-so, like I'll never forget some of the things that like they said to me that I remember, whether it's a quote or whatever it may be, you know, whatever lessons they learned while they were here that helped them turn it around and move forward. To me, that's pretty cool, you know, to better affect people's lives like that.